gene therapy and genetic alteration in all other organisms. The main danger is the danger of ecological disaster. So the danger for, I'll give you a great example, we are now, not I, but other people, other scientists, are making mosquito strains that will cannot carry viruses like West Nile virus or like Zika virus. But when they mate with the wild mosquito strains, the wild mosquito strain doesn't reproduce, but the genetically modified mosquito strain reproduces, outcompetes the wild strain, and now you have the new mosquito strain that's safe. Of course, some people are scared, but the elimination of malaria would be an incredible human achievement. It would rank with the landing on the moon. The danger there is some effect that we don't know about and ecological disaster. You eliminate mosquitoes and all of a sudden all the butterflies are gone. Okay? Okay. The second arena of genetic manipulation is genetic manipulation in human cells, but that does not affect sperm and eggs. Okay? So blood cells, brain cells, liver cells, skin cells, all of these cells. This is called somatic gene therapy. We are already doing this in humans. And the main concern there is biological disaster. By that I mean that you will cause cancer. That's the biggest concern. Or the organ will be rejected by the immune system. You'll get an immune relapse of some sort. That's another big concern. The third kind is the most complicated. And that is to make changes in human sperm cells or egg cells or embryos or sperm or egg making cells, all the same. What's the difference? In this case, if you make the change in the genes, not only is the human being born with it, but every other human being that comes from that human being will be born with it. Okay? So in other words, this is a permanent change in the human genome carried from generation to generation. Not true for number one, not true for number two. This is called germline gene therapy. Now, there are national and now international laws that say we should not be doing germline gene therapy unless we want to change a disease of extraordinary suffering. This is an important guideline because this is not to be trivial. You can't do this trivially, but who defines extraordinary suffering? Yeah? Scientists in white coats? You? Your child has a terrifying disease. Are you going to define extraordinary suffering based on that child? So, of course, these are questions. Germline gene therapy is obviously, because of the permanence of it, the most ethically challenging. It's also the most technically challenging. It's the most technically difficult to do. My prediction is that in our lifetimes, we will see the first germline gene therapy manipulated human born. My prediction is such a human being will be born in our lifetimes. My suspicion is he or she will be born in China. And that's where we will see a new frontier. We will be the generation where we see the birth of the first genetically modified human being. Are we going to reinvent eugenics, you mean?
Yes.
Look, eugenics has been part of human history from the beginning. We have always, eugenics has two faces. One is the dark face of eugenics, you're familiar with it. Nazi Germany, but also United States and other countries. The modification of human beings for better purposes. But the fundamental purpose, the original meaning of the word eugenics was to make a better human being. Who defines a better human being? Some Nazi politician in Germany? Some bureaucrat in the United States? You, me? What authority do we have to define what a better human being is? So the impulse to make better human beings is an ancient impulse. The problem is we are still struggling. I'll end my talk on a philosophical note. We're still struggling as a human species to define what is a better human being. I don't know the answer, but I do know that the struggle will continue, and I do know that in the next 10 years, we will encounter this question with 10 times more force because now we have the technologies. Now we didn't have the technologies before, we increasingly have the technologies to be able to ask these kinds of questions.